Hello friends, this is Rakshita from Vyans Medical Academy. I am here to say something interesting with you guys. At first, we all know that every organism is composed of millions of cells. From unicellular to multicellular, every organism has many cells. Have you ever wondered what is the mechanism behind the division of cell? How does the cell divide? To know all about that, let's enter into our topic, cell cycle and cell division. Cell cycle and cell division. Cell division is a process which occurs in cell cycle. And cell cycle is mainly divided into interphase and M phase. Interphase takes the most of the time, that is 95% of the time is taken by interphase, but no actual division of cell occurs over here. In M phase, it takes 5% of the time, but the actual division of cell occurs over there. But we can consider interphase as a useless phase, because in interphase, the cell gets ready and prepares itself for the division in M phase. Now let's learn about interphase and M phase clearly. Interphase is again subdivided into G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. In G1 phase, the cell is metabolically active and cell growth continues. And over here we can find a checkpoint. We can find a checkpoint in which every cell is asked whether it is interested in further division or not. If a cell says it is interested for the further division, then it is allowed to the further division. If it is not interested in the division, it enters into another phase known as G0 phase. G0 phase is also called as quiescent stage. In G0 phase, the cell is metabolically active, but temporarily it doesn't divide. In G0 phase, some cellular changes occur, such as vascular changes, protoplasmic changes, and new synthesis of cell wall, and at last, the cell increases in its size. In G0 phase, we can find permanent cells. And again to S phase. S phase is considered as the important phase in interphase, because DNA molecules, DNA doubles and centrioles doubles. What are centrioles? Centrioles are the cell organelles which are responsible for the formation of spindle fibers. Centrioles are found in animals and absent in plants. Then who is the responsible for formation of spindle fibers in plants? Spindle fiber apparatus is responsible for the formation of spindle fibers in plants. The spindle fibers formed from the centrioles are called as astral rays, just like in animals. And the spindle fibers formed from the spindle fiber apparatus are called as anastral rays. And one point needed to be noted that in S phase, the DNA doubles but not the chromosome number. And in G2 phase, the cell is metabolically active and the cell growth continues. So it is similar to G1 phase. But over here, anaphase promoting factor, which is responsible for the further division in M phase, is prepared. And this is the end of interphase. And interphase consumes most of the time, that is 95%. And in M phase, 5%. And M phase is of three types: mitosis, mitosis, meiosis. Mitosis is a primitive one which occurs very rarely in only some, we can find it on only some bacteria. Mitosis is formed without formation of any spindle fiber apparatus, and it is very primitive one, and we find it very rarely. And mitosis and meiosis are found frequently. And let's know the differences mainly in between mitosis and meiosis. In mitosis, the end product is two cells. We can find two cells at the end of the division in mitosis. In meiosis, we can find four cells at the end of the division. In mitosis, only one spindle fiber is formed. And in meiosis, we can find three spindle fiber apparatus. And in mitosis, the haploidy remains the same. And in meiosis, the haploidy is reduced to half. Recombination doesn't occur in mitosis. Recombination occurs in meiosis. And I will teach you about mitosis today. Mitosis is again divided into prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Okay. The chromosome up to S phase is like this, because I have mentioned that there is no doubling of DNA molecules up to S phase. So the chromosome is like this, and after S phase, from S phase we can find the chromosome like this. And the parts, centromere is the middle gum-like substance which holds all the chromosomal arms. So these are chromosomal arms, and this whole one is considered as a chromatid. And thus these both are sister chromatids. And this is the protein part and a disc-shaped part called kinetochore. which is present around centromere, and it is responsible for the attachment of spinal fibers to it during division. And these are called as telomeric ends, and this is the structure of a chromosome during division. And let's enter into mitosis. Mitosis, the first phase is prophase. In the prophase, the chromosome, the initiation of prophase can be identified by the condensation of the chromosomes into a compact like structure. The chromosome structure is irregular. The chromosome structure is irregular like this, and it's very hard to divide it during division. So nature has adopted a way to mold it into a compact structure. Division of this is very easy, right? And thus the condensation occurs in prophase. And at the end of prophase, we can find the condensed chromosomes scattered in the cell, and the disappearance of all the cell organelles such as nuclear membrane, nucleolus, and endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex. Okay, the centrioles which are divided in the S phase go to the opposite poles in prophase, and the initiation of metaphase can be identified by the attachment of spinal fibers formed from the centrioles to the chitinocores, and they exhibit the pull and push movements, and they try to arrange all the chromosomes on a central plate, on a plate called as metaphase plate. And thus the metaphase ends, and metaphase is the phase in which we can study the chromosome properly in laboratories, and thus it's a crucial phase. And then the anaphase. In anaphase is the most prominent phase of the cell cycle, because the splitting of chromosomes occurs over here. In anaphase, the centromere, which is a gum-like substance, splits into two due to the pulling movements of the spindle fibers attached to the chitinocores, and thus this both split, and thus two new chromosomes are formed. And this is over here, this is represented over here, you can see this. And due to the pulling movements, they attach to the centriole at a point, and this appears like this. The chromosomes which are split and exhibit different shapes after attaching to the centriole. And later we can find the telophase. Telophase is considered as the opposite phase to prophase, because the condensed chromosomes in prophase again become decondensed. The chromosomes which are condensed over here, and now this is the new chromosome, right? And this is again decondensed over here into a regular irregular shape. And again the new cell organelles such as nucleolus, nuclear membrane, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, which disappeared in prophase, reappears in telophase. Thus prophase and telophase are totally opposite phases, friends. And next, karyokinesis has been completed. Karyokinesis means the division of nucleus is called as karyokinesis. And next, the cytokinesis need to be happened. The karyokinesis must be followed by cytokinesis. Cytokinesis appears in forms in two forms, in plant cells and in animal cells. In animal cells, the cell wall is absent, thus the plasma membrane is extensible. And if you consider this as an animal cell, a furrow is formed in between the both, in the middle, and thus the furrow meets at the middle, and thus the both cells get divided. In such way, the plants animal cells divides. See, we can find over here a furrow is formed, and if they meet in the middle, the both cells are divided. Okay, and this happens from outside to inside, and thus it's considered as centripetal form. And in plant cells, as the cell wall is present, the cell wall is inextensible and it is not flexible. The plant cell has adopted to divide by forming a middle lamella material. Middle lamella material is formed by the help of Golgi complex, and the Golgi complex places its vesicles on the metaphase plate, which has formed earlier in metaphase. The Golgi complex vesicles are formed in this way, in this direction, from the middle. to the periphery and from the middle to the periphery, and thus it's considered as centrifugal wave. And thus the cytokinesis has been completed and the mitosis is completed totally. In general, we confuse a lot for meiosis and mitosis. I want to give you a good clarity in the difference between meiosis and the mitosis. For example, this is a male father, right? And this is female parent. And if they gametes, and if they give the gametes of same ploidy, that is 2N and 2N. If they both fuse, what is the ploidy formed? Yeah, 4N. If the 4N ploidy is formed, it's totally agonist and it's not fair and it's ridiculous and it's opposite to nature. To correct this, nature has adopted a way that is called as reduction division. Reduction division is nothing but meiosis. In meiosis, the ploidy is reduced to half, that is 2N is reduced to N and 2N is reduced to N, right? And this, if they both fuse, the forming ploidy is 2N, which is correct. And thus, nature has corrected the number of chromosomes in the progeny. And this is the end of the mitosis. And friends, and this is the end of my chapter. And the scope of this chapter is, it's a base for many chapters such as plant growth and development, reproduction in plants, and genetics, molecular basis of inheritance, plant kingdom. It's the base. And I hope that you all got my point very clearly. And please don't confuse between mitosis and meiosis. In mitosis, the progeny ploidy remains same, and in meiosis, the progeny ploidy is reduced to half. It is the main difference between them both of them. And I give you assurance of 100% that you could find 2 questions from this lesson directly in your NEET exam. Very important chapter, work out on this chapter. Vyans Medical Academy wishes you a very, very good luck for your NEET exam in 2019.